All right. I've already mentioned my trepidation at becoming the weatherman, but in the spirit of being a spiritual weatherman, let me just hope that one day our love for one another is as common to us as the weather. We've got a big storm blowing in, so I'm running out here into a windy, stormy potential of a day to share something that I found beautiful. It's very similar to something I've talked about before and alluded to before, but I find it beautiful enough to mention twice. It's a story about the sage Narada, who went everywhere singing the name of God and just loving everything and everyone he ran into. So the story goes like this. There was a great sage called Narada. Just as there are sages among mankind, great yogis, so there are great yogis among the gods. Narada was a good yogi, and very great. He traveled everywhere. One day he was passing through a forest and saw a man who had been meditating until the white ants had built a huge mound around his body. So long had he been sitting in that position. He said to Narada, "Where are you going?" Narada replied, "Well, I'm going to heaven." "Then ask God when he will be merciful to me. When shall I attain freedom?" Further on, Narada saw another man. He was jumping about and singing and dancing and said, "Oh, Narada, where are you going?" His voice and his gestures were wild. And Narada said, "I'm going to heaven." "Then ask when I shall be free." Narada went on. In the course of time, he came again by the same road, and there was the man who had been meditating with an anthill around him. He said, "Oh, Narada, did you ask the Lord about me?" "Oh, yes." "Well, what did he say?" "The Lord told me that you would attain freedom in 4 more births." Then the man began to weep and wail and said, "I have meditated until an anthill has grown around me, and I have 4 more births to go." Narada went on to the other man. He asked, "Did you ask my question?" Narada said, "Oh, yes. Do you see this tamarind tree? I have to tell you that as many leaves as there are on that tree, so many times you shall be born, and then you shall attain freedom." The man began to dance for joy and said, "I shall be have freedom after such a short time." A voice came, "My child, you shall have freedom this minute." That was the reward for his perseverance. He was ready to work through all of those births. Nothing discouraged him. But the first man felt that even 4 more births were too long. Only perseverance, like that of the man who is willing to wait eons, brings about the highest result. Oh my gosh, what a great story. What an encouragement. I can only imagine if that guy had as many tamarind trees, it's probably at least as many trees as on the ground around me right now for me, who knows. But the thing is never to be discouraged. And what that implicates is that we start our relationship with God now. There's this horrible thing in religion where we somehow think that after we die, something begins, that all of the things and wonders and joys of being in the presence of the divine happens later. Well, if that's the case, you're completely blind. You've completely lost the purpose of your life. Your life now, to see God everywhere, to dance and jump about like that second inquirer there, was so happy to learn that even after 1,000 births, he would realize God. That was nothing to him. He knew the value of his endeavor and enjoyed it in the moment, so that he was dancing already. He was joyful already. Be joyful already. Know that you are the beloved's very own. Know that nothing you can do or say or think that yourself to be can separate you from that divine love and from that infinite potential of this human life. Take advantage of it. Be kind to yourself. Be gentle with yourself. Persevere, persevere, and persevere. When you make a mistake, admit you made a mistake, forget it, and move on. There's no room for shame in spiritual life. There's no room for it at all. Be free. You're a child of the Beloved, which means within you exists the capability to feel love, to give love, to be loved.